Okay. In the last class, I told you about the circular convolution. এখন জয়েন করাবো. In the last class, I told you about the circular convolution and how the circular convolution can be done between two sequences using matrix method, that is also shown. Today we will show you how you can use circular convolution to calculate linear convolution and how you can use linear convolution to calculate circular convolution. So first come suppose x1 n is given as 1 2 3 4 and x2 n is given as 1 2 1 2. What you have to do, you have to do the linear convolution of x1 and x2 by using circular convolution. Keep in mind, you have to do the linear convolution by using circular convolution method. Means you will have the result x1n, that is your linear convolution, x2n, that you will calculate, but the method whatever you will use will be x1n circular convolution x2n. Using that method you have to get that result. I think the question is clear. In linear convolution, you know that length L define m plus n minus 1, where m is length of one sequence, n is the length of other sequence minus 1. So length of first sequence is 4, length of second sequence is 4. So suppose this is m, this is n, so 4 plus 4 minus 1 will be 7. So 7 will be the length of the linear convoluted value. Now here, to calculate the linear convolution using circular convolution, we will use the matrix method. In matrix method, what is happening? In matrix method, we will write x1 here and we will write x2 here. All of we know that. Now x1 writing procedure is what? 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. Again 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. But there is a small change. The change is that we have to do the linear convolution, means the length must be 7. In the result, length must be 7. So length of x1 must be 7 cross 7. So that is 4 values. So what you have to do, other 3 values you have to make 0. Already I have told you, in circular convolution both the length must be same and 0 padding will be there. In case of circular linear convolution, using circular convolution, both of the length must be that 7. So 0 padding will be there for both cases. 30 will be added here and 30 will also be added here. So that is your first column. What will be your second column? Just check it very carefully. In the second column, you will start 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 0. You should not write anything here. Third column, you will write from here 1, 2, 3, 4, 0. The fourth column, you will write from here 1, 2, 3, 4. Like that, keep in mind. Fifth column 1, 2, 3. Sixth column 1, 2. And the seventh column 1. Means diagonally we have considered 1 and we have fill up the lower part. And whatever the upper part, remaining upper part you have, you will just fill up by zeros. Keep in mind, you will not make the circular shift here. Here you will make all the values as zeros. Keep in mind, that is important, and that will define your linear convolution using circular convolution. That all the values will be zeros. Clear? So whether you will take x1 or x2 here, you have to write that in that way. If we write x2, so 1, 2, 1, 2, and all the values will be like that. So we have written here x1, so x2 will be here. X2 is 1, 2, 1, 2, and other three part will be simply 0. So that is 7×1 matrix. Clear? Clear or not? Okay. So that is your linear convolution using circular convolution. Now simply multiply will be your result. So first value will be 1 × 1, 1. All the other addition will be 0. So first value will be 1. Similarly, if we calculate all the values, you will get a value like 1, 4, 8, 14, 15, 10, and 8. So that will be your output. That output is the linear convolution of these two. If we simply calculate linear convolution of x1 and x2, you will get that result. So that makes easier to calculate linear convolution using circular convolution if you use the matrix method. So that length, you can check it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Length will also be 7. Okay, so that is your linear convolution using circular convolution. And if you want to do the opposite, means you have to do the circular convolution using linear convolution. Then two sequences are given, x1 n as 1, 2, 3, x2 n as 1, 2, 3, 4, suppose. So you have to use the linear convolution to calculate the circular convolution between these two. Means that will be your result. That will be your result, but the method must be that. Method will be linear convolution, result will be the result of circular convolution. Okay, so to do that, what you will do, you have to use the linear convolution procedure. That means initially you cannot use zero, you cannot use zero padding here, because in linear convolution you don't need to do the zero padding. What you need to do, just mention x1 value and x2 value like that, or opposite, you can consider x2 value here, x1 value here, and write all the values. X1 defines values 1, 2, 3. X2 defines values 1, 2, 3, 4. Keep in mind that matrix will consider the same length. So what you will do, we will consider a 0 here. In that matrix we will consider a 0 here, and we will multiply that value with all these values, this x2 values with all x1 values, and we will write here like 1 into 1 will give you 1, 1 into 2 will give you 2, 3, 0. Again this value with everyone, so multiplication will be there, so it will be 2, 4, 6, 0, 3, 6, 9, 0, 4, 8, 12, 0. Okay, now what you need to do, for each and every angular value, you have to separate it like that. Each and every angular value, you have to separate it like that. After separation, for each, every angular value will be added up with each other, and your result will be that. Means from here, if we write your result yn, yn will be first, here only 1 is there, so only 1 will be there, 1. In the second angle, 2 and 2 are there, so 2 plus 2, 4 will be there. Then third angle, 3, 4, 3 you have, so 3 plus 3, 6 plus 4, 10 will be the third result. Fourth result will be 6 plus 6, 12 plus 4, 16, 12 4 plus 4, 16. Fourth angular result will be 9 plus 8, ah, that's solo, 17. 17, fifth result will be how much? 12. 12, and sixth result will be 0. 0. So that will be your output if we use circular convolution using linear convolution. So that will be your output. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. See, in that case, length is 7. The length does not consider 4. For circular convolution, length considered 4. But if we consider the linear convolution procedure, whatever the length for linear convolution, the length of circular convolution will be that. Clear or not? Okay, keep in mind that x1 and x2 value you can flip also. You can take x2 here, you can take x1 here also. So that is your linear convolution using circular convolution. Next is one important property of convolution that you have to keep in mind. Property is, if two sequences given, two sequences are given, xn and hn, you have to do the convolution between xn and hn, circular convolution. Xn circular convolution hn, if we want to do that, and if we calculate the DFT of that circular convoluted result, DFT of that circular convoluted result, the result will be the multiplication of the DFTs of individual, means multiplication of xk and hk. Xk is the DFT of xn and hk is the DFT of hn. So DFT of circular convolution of two values will be the result of multiplication of two individual DFTs. Okay, it has proof. That proof will be your own task. How to do that? Just try it. If you are not able to do that, I will show you. Simply in your equation, n equal to 0 to n minus 1, just in the place of xn, you will write xn convolution hn and will continue the operation. And finally, you will get that result. Just try it at your home. And the opposite thing. Opposite thing means, if you have DFT, or if you have multiplication of these two sequence, xn multiplication hn, and if you calculate the DFT of xn into hn, that will give you 1 by n circular convolution of individual DFTs. Circular convolution of individual DFTs means, if you have xk, if you have hk, you need to calculate xn and hn. Directly you will do the circular convolution between xk and hk, multiply by 1 by n, you will get the DFT of xn and hn. Okay, so there is proof of these two. You must try at your home, and if that proof you are not able to do that, then I will tell you. So up to that, whatever I have told you, that is the circular convolution. So from the circular convolution, if you have any question, you can ask me. If not, then I will go to the next point. Okay. So very important point, very important topic, that should be the last topic of our today's class. So keep in mind, the topic named as overlap save method. So this method we generally use when a large number of input sequence will be given and we need to do the DFT of that sequence, then we should use overlap save method. Suppose xn that we have considered as 7, 6, 4, 5, 2, 4, 5, 2, 3. That is your xn, and hn 1, 2, 3. Depending on these two value, you have to calculate DFT of xn considering the impulse responses HN by using the overlap save method. That is the problem. And to solve the overlap save method, we need to use some steps, which are: the first step is to find out L, M, N. L, M, and N. Where L defines the padded zeros values, zeros that is defined as M minus 1, and M defines the number of element, number of elements in HN, and that value is 3. Number of elements in HN are 3. So obviously L will be 2. And N defines the total number of samples that will be equal to L plus M minus 1. So that will be 4. So this is the first step. You need to calculate the values of L, M, and N. Whenever you have got those values, whenever you have got those values, you have to go to your second step. The second step defines that number of sample in HN must be equal to that N. Number of sample at HN will be equal to capital N. So number of sample of HN you have 3, capital N is 4. So what you have to do, you have to add one extra 0 so that the sample of HN must be 4. So step 2 defines number of samples in HN must be equal to N. Must be equal to N. So HN will be equal to 1, 2, 3, 0. So that is your second step. So for reference, I am writing number of padded zeros is defined by L. Number of padded zeros are defined by L. The value of L equal to M minus 1. So value of M is what? Value of M is the number of element in HN. So number of element in HN is 1, 2, 3. So 3 element you have. So value of M is 3. So 3 minus 1 equal to 2. So number of padded zeros values is 2. Okay. and so HN must be same length of capital N, so we have to use one extra zero to HN. So till now we have got the values of L, M, N and HN. Now in step 3, you have to calculate the set of xns. The set of xn will be defined as x1n, x2n, like that. And how to calculate those values? That set of xn will be the size of capital N. Whatever the size of capital N you have, the set of xn will also be of same size. So first, what you have to do, for each and every set of xn, you have to draw a box which will contain of 4 size. After drawing that box, you need to fill up that box by the values. How will you fill up the box? First the box will fill up by zeros. So how many zeros you need to add here, that will be defined by L. Whatever the value of L, that much zeros, first you need to add to the box of x1n. So we have L equal to 2. So 2 zeros will be added here. After that, you have to take the values from xn to fill up the other 2 part. Now that xn, you will consider first 2 value of xn to fill up x1n, like 7 and 6. So that will be your x1n. Now in the same way, you have to calculate x2n, but the box for x2n will start from the middle of x1n. Like that. The box will start from the middle of x1n. That is your middle. So from here, the box will start of x2n. And the first 2 value of the box will be defined by the same value of the previous box. Okay. Or which boxes are overlapping, that overlapping values will be put here. So in the second box, that is for x2n, first value will be 7, second value will be 6, and next 2 values will be filled up by the xn values 4 and 5. That will be 4, 5. Yes. In x1, okay, first you have to calculate the set of xn as x1, x2, x3, like that, and each and every set of xn will be of size 4, means will be of size capital N. Okay, so capital N is 4. So x1n, x2n, x3n, all of xn sets will be of size 4. And that 4 size will be defined by 4 boxes. So x1n will be defined by 4 box. box 1, box 2, box 3, box 4. So that 4 box will be filled up by the values. And to fill up the values, the procedure is the first value will be 0. Box's first value will be 0. And how many 0 you have to put here? That value will be equal to the number of padded zeros, means number of L. If value of L is 2, that means 2 0 will be added to x1 first. So depending on L, we have added 2 zeros, and next 2 values will be taken from xn as 7 and 6. That 7 and 6 will be filled up by next 2 values. So that is your x1n. Clear? Okay. In that way, whenever you will calculate x2n, x2n will also contain a box of size 4, but the box will start from the middle of the box x1n. That means from here it will start. And you can see that last two value of x1n will be overlap to the first two value of x2n. That you have to maintain. The last two values of first box will be overlap to the first two value of second box. So if it overlaps like that, so first two values of second box, that is first two value of x2n, will be 7 and 6. And next two gap will be filled up by next two values of xn, that is 4 and 5. So 7, 6, 4, 5. That is the value of x2n. Similarly, to calculate x3n, x3n will contain a box of size 4, and that box will start from the middle of x2n, and these are the overlapping values, so it will be filled up as 4 and 5. Other two values will be considered from xn, 2 and 4. So that process will continue until or unless all the values are taken. So next is x4n. X4n will also contain a box of size 4. Box of size 4. It will start from the middle of x3n, and that is your overlapping values. So 2, 4, and that two values. 5, 2. 5, 2. So x5n. X5n will be 5, 2, next 3. So 3 will be filled up, and that value we don't have, so that will be filled up by 0. Okay, the last value we have 3, and after 3 we don't have any value, so that value will be filled up by 0. Now you have to keep in mind that each and every values of xn, first 7, 6 is overlapping here. Then this 4, 5 is overlapping here. Similarly, 2, 4 is overlapping here. 5, 2 is overlapping here. That 3 is not overlapping. So you have to write another line of xn so that 3 will also be overlapped. So to write that xn, that will be x6n, and again it will start from the middle of x5n, and it will contain 4 box. That 3 will be overlapped. Baki others value will be 0, as we don't have any other values. So baki all others values will be zeros. So here you can check that all the values of xn are getting overlapped. Clear or not? X1 in, whatever the values of xn you will have, always you will consider the first values of xn. It does not mean that you have to take two digit. Suppose x1n is of size 5. Okay. Suppose capital N you have got 5. So obviously x1n will be of size 5. And in that case, if L is equal to 2, so first two value will be 0. And next three value will be taken from xn. Then what you have to do? That three values will have to be overlapped. Clear? So in that way, you have to do the overlapping. Up to that, clear or not? Up to that? Okay. Just keep in mind that each and every value should be overlapped. Finally, the single value that you are getting, that should also be overlapped. If there is two value, then that two value will also be overlapped finally by adding extra zeros. So these are your x1 to x6 that you have to keep in mind. So I need space. So I am writing the values of x1 to xn here so that I can erase the part. x1n 0076, x2n 7645, x3n 4524, x4n 2452, and x5n 5230, x6n that you have got 3000. So these are the values you have got from step 3. Now in the step 4, what you have to do, you have to do the circular convolution of each values of x with h. Circular convolution of each values of x with h. Like, for the first value, that x1n will be circular convoluted to hn to get the value y1n. So y11 will be what? That will be your hn. Hn is of 1, 2, 3, 0. We are considering the matrix method. 1, 2, 3, 0. 1, 2, 3, 0. 1, 2, 3, 0. So that is your hn. And that is your x1n 0076. So if we do the circular convolution between x1n and hn, you will get your y1n. Value of y1n, you can check it. It will be 33, 18, 7 and 20. Clear? So that will be your y1n. Similarly, you have to calculate y2n, y3n, y4n up to y6n. So y2n that you will get, that hn multiplied by x to n. So if you multiply hn to the x to n, hn value will be the same. Hn value will be the same. It will remain same. That will be multiplied by x to n, that is 7, 6, 4, 5. So if you multiply it by 7, 6, 4, 5, so the value that you will get, value will be 29, 35, 37 and 31. 29, 35, 37 and 31. Clear? In that way, you will calculate x1 n2 x6 n. Clear or not? After that, clear or not? Okay. So I am not calculating here all the values, just I am writing the values. Just put the values of hn and xn and just multiply, matrix multiplication, you will get your yn. So in that way, first value 40 coming out. 1 into 0 will be 0 plus that 0 into 0 will be 0 plus 3 into 7 21 plus 2 into 6 12. Okay. So the values that you are getting, y1 n will be 33 18 7 20, y2 n that will be 29 35 37 31 Y3N, that you will get 18, 25, 24 and 23. 18, 25, 24, 23. Y4N, you will get 21, 14, 19, 24. Y5N, that you will get 14, 12, 22, 12. And finally, Y6N, that you will get 3690. So these are the y values. If we calculate, you will get. Now after getting the y values, come to the next step. Whatever the next step, 4 or 5, whatever. Come to the next step. In the next step, you should write down all the y values as you have written for x values. Means x1, x2, whatever the values you have written from x1 to x6, in the same way, you have to write y1 to y6. So, y1 n will be a 4 box and the values will be, you don't need to do here anything. Just you have to put the values 33, 18, 7, 20. Just put the values 18, 7, 20. Y2N will start here. That will be 29, 35, 37, 31. So 29, 35, 37, and 31. That is your y2n. and y3n will be 18, 25, 24, 23. Y3n. Y4n will be 21, 14, 19, 24. Y5n that you have got 14, 12, 22, 12. So 14, 12, 22, 12. And finally, Y6N that you have got 3, 6, 9, 0. From here, you will get your values. What will be the values of yn from here? Yk will be your DFT value of xk. From here, you will get your yk values. And to write down the yk values, again, you will find out first what are the overlapping points. This is your overlapping point first. This is your second overlapping point. This is your third overlapping point. This is your fourth. And this is your fifth. These are your overlapping points. Okay. So from that, of after finding out the overlapping points, you will take yk value as the overlapping value of the previous y value, means between y1 and y2, these are the overlapping values 7, 20, 21, 35. This is 29. 7, 20, 29, 35. These are the overlapping values for y1 and y2. So, yk value you will take from y1. First overlapping value. So first values will be 7, 20. Clear or not? Okay. So first overlapping checked. Come to the second overlapping. In the second overlapping, between y2 and y3 is overlapping is happening, and the values are 37, 31, 18, 25. So, from Y2, you will take 37, 31. From the first Y value, keep in mind. Between Y2 and Y3, Y2 is first. So, from the first Y2 value, you will take the overlapping values. That is 37 and 31 for this case. So, next values will be 37, 31. Similarly, between Y3 and Y4, you will consider 24, 23. 24 and 23. Similarly, between Y4 and Y5, you will consider 19 and 24. So, 19 and 24. And from Y5 and Y6, you will consider 22 and 12. So, 22 and 12. And the remaining part that you have to add. The remaining part are 9 and 0. Keep in mind, remaining part that you have to add finally, that is 9 and 0. So, this will be your yk value with respect to xn. So, that will be your DFT of xn. Clear or not? How to find out the yk, tai to?
Okay.
The all the values of y's, set of y's, that is y1 to y6, you have got. Now, what you will do, as you have written x1 to x6, in the same way, you have to write y1 to y6. But in that case, the box will be filled up simply by the values of y's. First value of y, that is y1, at 33, 18, 7, 22. So y1 will be filled up by 33, 18, 7 and 22. So that is y1. Next will be y2. The box of y2 will obviously start from the middle of y1 and the values will be 29, 35, 37, 31. Similarly, y3, y4, y5 and y6. All the values we have written here. So after that, you have to check the overlap values, overlapping values. Between y1 and y2, the overlapping values are 7, 20, 29, 35. Between y2 to y3, overlapping values are 37, 31, 18, 25. Overlapping means matching of boxes. So last two box of y1 and first two box of x1 are overlapping each other. That means these values are overlapping values. So in that way, between y1 to y3, between y1 to y2, y2 to y3, y3 to y4, y4 to y5, y5 to y6, all the overlapping values we have considered. So 5 set of overlapping values we have got. From that 5 set of overlapping values, which will be your yk values? The yk values will be, for each set, first yn values will be considered as yk values. First yn overlapping values means between y1n and y2n, between these two overlapping values are this. So first two overlapping values are the 7 and 20. Okay, between y1n and y2n, we will consider y1n. Similarly, between y2 and y3, we will consider y2, the first y values. Between y3 and y4, we will consider y3, like that. So y1 and y2, you have y1 overlapping are 7 and 20. So 7 and 20 will be your first yk value. Then come to overlapping between y2 and y3. So between y2 and y3, obviously you will consider y2. Because y2 is the first y value. So from y2, overlappings are 37 and 31. So next will be 37, 31. That will be your yk. In the same way, 24, 23, 19, 24, 22, 12. So up to that, all the overlapping you have considered. And finally, whatever the values you have, that is 9 and 0, that you have to add up with the yk. So 12, 9, 0. That will be your final yk value. For xk, this. For this xk value, considering impulse response hn 1, 2, 3, yk value will be this. So that will be your final result by using overlapping sieve method. Clear or not? Okay. Now, one thing is that whenever you are solving it manually, it looks like very tough. It looks like very time taking. But matter is that whenever the computer will access the parameter, that structure
of calculating the overlapping shape method will already be there. Simply values will be put there and the values will be extracted. Only that thing will operate, that thing will happen to your computer or DSP processor. So the time taken by the computer will be very less if we consider simply convolution method between xn and hn. In that case, time will be very much more considering to overlapping shape method. Clear? Yes. See, practically we can't say, because xn may be of size 1000, may be of size 1500, may be of size 500, may be of size 100. So it varies depending on the signal. Suppose we are repeating a signal like that, 1 1 1 1 1 1, like that. So the size will be less, because it will be dependent on the periodicity. But if we create a signal like that, 1, 1, 1, like that, in that case, size will be high, because periodicity value will be much more. So how the signal you are creating or how the signal you are getting from the source, that is completely dependent on the source. So you can't say the size must be that much or size must be this much. Whatever the size you will get, simply length of xn, if we write, you will get the size. Means in your MATLAB code, if we write length of xn, you will get the size. For this case, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. For this case, length of xn will give you 9. Okay, so in that case, we find out the size, and depending on that, we do the calculation. Clear? Okay. The size that does matter is the size of HN, that is dependent on us. We cannot control xn, because xn is the input signal that we need to calculate the frequency response. But the impulse response that we are using to calculate the frequency response of xn is dependent on us. If we consider hn of size more, here we have considered hn of size 3. In that case, if we consider hn of size more, so it will take less time, because for this case, suppose you are considering HN as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, size like that. So what will be your M value? M will be 6. So L will be 5, N will be 6 plus 5 minus 1. So 10. Right? So what you have to do? You have to make H of size 10. In that case, whenever you will find out XN, that must be of size more than 10. Otherwise, you cannot fill up that box. Clear or not? Clear or not? Okay, I'm repeating. See, xn is given. Okay, xn is given. Hn that you are controlling. Now, whatever the values of L, M and N you are getting, depending on that, if N is size of 6, suppose, or 10, if N is size of 10, Hn must be a size of 10. Initially, Hn is given of size of 6. So, what you have to do? You have to add 4 zeros to make 6 size, 4 size, total 10 size. In that case, if H is your size of 10, X must be size more than 10. If it does not happen, what the problem will happen? Whenever you will calculate x1n, the size of x1n will also be 10. Now, if the values of xn is not more than 10, so all the values of xn will be under x1n. So, if the size of xn is 9, size of xn is 9, so from 0, from first position to before the last position, all the values of xn will be there. One position will remain blank. If we fill up by 0, then also you cannot get the overlapping values, because after x1n you cannot find the x2n. Because already all the values of xn you have taken. Clear? So, what you have to do, depending on the length of xn, you have to consider hn such that the value of n does not exist to the length of xn. Value of n does not exist to the length of input xn. That you have to keep in mind. In that way you have to take the value hn. Clear or not? Okay. So, that is your overlap save method. Yes. DFT of xn. Whatever you are using convolution, you are using directly DFT equation, whatever, that final result will be your DFT of input signal xn. Okay. Next is your overlapping add method. Overlapping add method. What is happening here? That is little bit easier. Overlapping method to find out the TFT. So xn, consider any values, you can consider any values, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, suppose. And with respect to that, we have considered hn as 1, 1, 1, suppose. So you have to calculate xk or you have to calculate yk, whatever. Means the DFT of xn, that you need to calculate by using overlapping add method. So in that method, the step, the first step is same as overlapping step method, means you have to calculate L, M and N. In that step, if we calculate L, L is the padded 0, that is M minus 1, and M is the number of element of HN, that is 3. So value of M that you are getting 3. So obviously the value of L that you are getting 3 minus 1, 2. So N that you will get 3 plus 2 minus 1. So 4. So the first step is common for both. In step 2, you have to find out. In step 2 also HN must be size of capital N. HN must be size of capital N. So we will consider extra 0 to HN, means the HN will be 0 padded by 1 0. That will be your step 2. In step 3, you have to find out the set of XN, as x1n, x2n, like that. Here the set of xn will be like that. Size will be 4. So 4 position will be there. The last values, here the last values, keep in mind, the last values will be filled up by zeros of size L. L you have 2, that means last 2 value will be 0. And first 2 value will be filled up by xn. So 1, 2, 0, 0. That will be your x1n. You don't need to create box here because you don't need to show the overlapping, as we have shown for overlapping save method. You can write directly here x1n. Similarly, x2n, that will be in the same way. Size will be 4. Last two value will be 0. First two value will be that two values. Next values of xn, that is 3, 4. Similarly, x3n, 5, 6, 0, 0. X4n, 7, 8, 0, 0. Okay. So these are the four sets you will get. Clear or not? Clear? Okay. Yes, in this case last two zero will always define L and the first two values will define the value of xn. Okay, now as n is 4, that's why 4 size, depending on that values we have considered x1 and x2n. If that values are changing, or suppose length is 3, n is 6, so in that way you have to change the values structure also. Clear? For this case, that will be the structure. Now, length of nothing, if length of xn will be added, then zeros will be added. Suppose up to 7 you have, so last value will be 7, that value will be 0. Okay, just you have to match up 4. These two value will define by L, this value will define xn, that 0, as it is blank space, it will be filled by 0. Okay. So, that is 8. So, obviously, it will be 8. So, that is your x1 to x4. Now, similarly, you have to calculate y1 to y4 by circular convolution. So, y1 will be hn is 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1, 1, 0. So that is your hn. Circular shift is happening here. And that hn will be multiplied by x1n to get y1. Multiplied by x2 to get y2, multiplied by x3 to get y3, and multiplied by x4 to get y4. So if we do that, I am not showing the result, multiplication values, just writing here. If we do that, you will get y1n as 1, 3, 3, 2. I am writing that in a single row. 1, 3, 3, 2. That is your y1n. y2n. Yes. To calculate y1n, I am showing 1. That is your hn. I am multiplying x1n. 1, 2, 0. 0. If we multiply that, you will get y1n as 1332. Similarly, to get y2n, that hn will be multiplied by 33400 to get y2n. For y3n, it will be multiplied by 5600, like that. And the result that you will get, that I am writing here. y2n will be 3774. y3n will be 511116. y4n will be 715158. These are the four value of yn that you will get. Now, after getting yn, what you will do? After getting yn, you have to do the overlapping here. Overlapping means, now you have to write y1n, size of 4, obviously it will be also the same size as n. So y1n, that you have to write by overlapping structure. y1n is 1, 3, 3, 2. Again from the middle, y2n will be 3776. Y3n will be 511116, and last value is your 715158. So these are y1, y2, y3, and y4. So from here, to calculate or to find out yk or xk, whatever you can write, that is defined, that will define the DFT of xn. That will be, first you have to find out the overlapping. This is the first overlapping, this is the second overlapping, and this is the third overlapping. Now values will be, whatever the overlapping position, whatever the overlapping position you are getting, that overlapping position will be added and other values will be as it is. Means if we consider y1n, first value is 1, so it will be 1. Second value is 3, that is not overlapped, so it will be 3. Third value is overlapping values, 3 3, so 3 3 will be added, it will be 6. Fourth value is overlapped, 2 7 2 7 will be added, it will be 9. Now 3 7 already used for from y2, 3 7 already used here, so it will come to that position 7 and 4. That 7, 4 also overlap with 5 and 11. So 7 will be added to 5, 4 will be added to 11. 7 plus 5, 12, 4 plus 11, 15. Next y3, 5, 11 already used. So next is 11 and 6. 11 is overlap to 7, so it will be 18. And this 6 is overlapped to 15, so this will be 21. In y4, the remaining part is 15 and 8. So 15, 8. That will be your yk value if we use the overlapping add method. So clear or not? Okay, so these are the two techniques, very important techniques. Generally, whenever we will write down any code, we will use that to shorten our time, overlapping add method and overlapping save method.